should stay hidden if I don't want to fight.
Bearer, wonderful! Magistrate Xanthi has spoken highly of you.
Very kind of her.
So here's the thing. My children have promising futures, but they refuse to learn and study. They think they know better, but they can't recite a poem to save their lives.
Where do I fit into this?
They've heard of the Eagle Bearer and worship the ground you walk on. If you related an epic story to them, I'd bet they retain it and impress their tutors.
It's an odd request, but I've been asked to do stranger things. I'll do it.
My children are waiting inside the temple of Dionysus Colonatas for today's epic story. The subject is Perseus, which they should know well, but seem to forget all when questioned.
I know the story well, of course, but my preferred version may not be what your children expect.
Do not fear. If you need a reminder, there are many relics related to Perseus in the hall adjacent to the temple of Dionysus Colonatas.
Good to know. Hello, I'm...
The Eagle Bearer. We've heard all about you.
Are you going to tell us a story today? Do we have to listen? We've heard it 100 times.
Yes, that's me. And yes, I'm telling you a story. Gather round and listen, children, while I spin you the yarn of Perseus. Acrisius, the king of Argos, was not a good man. He had one child, a daughter, Danae. Bitter that he had no son, he went to the Oracle of Delphi and heard a prophecy that chilled him.
Ooh, what was it?
The Oracle said Acrisius would be killed by his grandson. But Danae was unmarried and childless at the time. To protect himself, he locked Danae in a bronze room open only to the sky.
Ooh!
However, mighty Zeus saw the girl and fell in love with her. He transformed into a golden shower and seduced her. Danae gave birth to a son, Perseus.
I knew it!
King Acrisius couldn't kill the boy for fear of angering Zeus. So he put his daughter and grandson in a wooden crate and tossed them into the wild sea to be drowned.
How horrid! Poor Perseus!
kindly old couple, Amphitryon and Alcmene, found Perseus in the sea and brought him to their farm in Smalpolis, taking him as their son.
What about his mom, my namesake?
Shh, listen. Lyra was angry, though, and sent snakes to kill the baby. But Perseus was too strong, and he strangled the snakes in his crib, revealing his godly nature.
That doesn't sound right.
There are different ways to tell the story, you know.
And this story is for the crows?
The cruel king of Seriphos, Dictys' brother, Polydectes, decided he wanted to marry Danae, for she was still beautiful and noble. But Perseus knows his mother does not want this. Dictys couldn't stop his brother, so it was up to Perseus to interfere and be annoying.
Christos, that's your job.
I will keep this stinky king from marrying you.
The cruel, stinky king became angry. To get rid of Perseus, Polydectes sent him on an impossible quest. Prove yourself a warrior and fetch me a worthy wedding gift, the king said, by killing a great monster.
I knew it!
Shh, I knew it too.
Polydectes told Perseus to bring back the head of Medusa, the Gorgon whose gaze could turn anyone who looked into her eyes to stone.
Ah!
Polydectes knew that Medusa would be Perseus' death.
That stinker!
But the evil king did not know Perseus was favored by the gods. Hermes gifted Perseus with winged sandals and a silver sickle, and Athena gave him a bronze shield, polished, mirror bright. Perseus flew to Medusa's lair and used the shield to watch her reflection. He cut off her head with the sickle of Hermes. As she died, the winged foal Pegasus sprung from her neck.
Yes!
Flying home, Perseus found the maiden Andromeda chained on the Ethiopian cliffs, waiting to be sacrificed to the baleful sea monster Ketos. Perseus used Medusa's head to turn Ketos to stone, rescued Andromeda, and married her.
Take that, Ketos!
Perseus returned home to find King Polydectes relentlessly pursuing Danae. They quarreled, and Perseus showed the king his wedding gift. When he saw Medusa's head, Polydectes turned to stone. Perseus traveled to Argos with his family, and one day competed in the great athletic games. He hurled the discus, and his throw was so great that it shot into the stands and struck King Acrisios. So doing, Perseus killed his grandfather and fulfilled the prophecy.
Hurrah!
You can't escape your fate.
In the end, Perseus and Andromeda settled in Mykene as king and queen, and had 7 sons and 2 daughters, the Perseidae.
Wow, that was so wrong and so boring.
You are a sticky storyteller, and that story was poop!
I am sorry for your audience, Eagle Bearer. Though from what I heard, it did sound like you deviated somewhat from the traditional tale.
Apologies.
Ωραία. You wouldn't happen to be the eagle bearer, would you?
Me? Yes, I am.
Where do you know justice? Your hair must have been woven by Athena. Your body is like a sculpture made by the masters. And your arms look so strong. Strong enough to carry this basket to my husband Kalibos.
Oh, right. The magistrate mentioned you. It'll be easy to carry.
Thank you so much. Let me know if you need anything.
Where might I find Kalibos?
He's an important general. His unit is stationed in the northeast near the fort of Presai, down by the beach.
What's in the basket?
What any man would need on the eve of battle to win the respect of the gods. Please, Eagle Bearer, it would give him an edge over his enemies.
I'll help with your delivery. What's in here? Bricks?
Amisthios? Well met. What brings you to our camp?
You are Kalibos? Your wife sent me to deliver this package. I think it might be some kind of offering.
Zephxo is a good woman. She's gifted me with a basket fit for Dionysos.
Earthly pleasures? She made it sound like it was a case of life and death.
A deathly hangover, maybe. Boys, we're having a good night. Care to join us, friend?
Are you sure you want your soldiers this intoxicated while in the field?
Oh, I must have misjudged you. Are you not also a Spartan? The only thing we're better at than fighting is drinking.
I see your point. I never say no to good wine and good company.
I expected no less from you.
Could someone pass the water skin?
Oh, could someone pass my head? I think I left it farther down the beach.
Surely this is the after effects of the mushrooms. I remember the chicken coop. I remember the farmer's field. I do not remember building a Trojan horse.
It was just here when I woke up.
We offer it to the gods for safe passage across the seas. Boys, let's move this down to the beach.
I don't trust that horse.
What happened?
I once boasted to a friend that I was a better tactician than Odysseus himself. Today I was proven wrong.
You live to fight another day. Learn from this.
Please, thank my wife for her festive gift.
I don't know if I should thank her or curse her. Sharp watch here. Thank you for aiding all of us in Pitana. Stories of you will live amongst us for many years.
I help what I can, but thank you.
A reward for all your help.
My lamb, you've been gone so long.
Brasidas is dead.
No.
Vimos killed him in battle.
And what of my son?
Cleon fired an arrow into Deimos' back. Wound didn't look fatal. He could still be alive.
Malakas, Cleon. I'll kill him with my bare hands.
It's done, Mater. I already sent that snake to the Styx.
My family. You're all I have left.
Mater, there's something I need to do. I need to go to Mount Taietos, where it all began. My whole life has been spent fighting and running. Running from my past, fighting to forget. I can't do this anymore.
My heart was shattered on that mountain.
I need to put that night behind me, once and for all.
I'm coming with you.
This is where everything changed. It's like I never left.
Alexios!
On the edge of the world, a mother calls out to her child. Touching.
Alexios, please.
You use that name as if it means something to me.
It's the name your father and I gave you.
Was that before or after you brought me to this mountain to die?
It was the cult. I tried to save you. I did everything. The priest told me you were dead.
And they told me you abandoned your son.
Alexios. Come to me. We are your family. We can go home.
Family? Home. My sword is my family. The battlefield is my home.
I promised to bring him back, Mater. But the cult has poisoned his mind.
Promise to bring me back to Mater, did you? You didn't bring me here. Why don't you tell our Mater the truth?
And what truth is that?
That I'm the chosen one. I'm the one with a destiny. I will bring order to this world.
You're nothing but a mercenary with a broken spear.
The cult controls your destiny, but you don't need them. Together, we can destroy them and bring peace back to this world.
Peace. And what under Helios would you do with yourself if there was peace? Milk the goats? Look at you! Oh, mighty Mystios. You profit from this war as much as I do. You don't want peace. You just don't want to deal with me.
What I want
What I have always wanted is my family.
When I was little, I found a lion cub trapped in a snare. My friend tried to free it. That's when I heard the deadly growl of its mother. I watched as the lioness tore my friend to bloody shreds. Even in the world of beasts, a family protects its young!
I loved you! I still love you.
The one you love is dead. My destiny is clear. And I won't let you get in my way.
Alexios, listen to me. You are my brother. I tried to protect you once, and I failed. I will not fail again. This belonged to our grandfather. Sometimes the face we show to the world needs to be one of strength, despite the chaos we harbor beneath.
There's more to being the best than pure strength.
That's an excuse for the weak.
I'll show you who's weak.
Well, at least the family is all together.
I'll get more wine.
Huh?
wasn't so bad, was it?
I can't believe I have a family again.
The gods work in mysterious ways. You never know what they have planned.
Someone's kept their eye on me.
You're special! Look at the life they've blessed you with! Not so bad, if you think of it all.
That's optimistic, considering.
Just remember, no matter who surrounds you, I'll be there. And the others are waiting for us on the ship.
Right behind you.